Well, we did it. We got to Astoria. Astoria is where the Goonies took place, so that's exciting for us.
Kids on bikes.
Yeah. I love kids on bikes movies. We got here, we pulled in, and we just immediately put on the Goonies and started watching it.
Do you want me to blow your mind?
Yeah.
Look out the window to your right.
There's bars on the window?
Look right here. Look out your window. What is it?
The jail!
Remember who was here? Tell me the story.
The mean brother was here. The lady said, come on.
Yeah.
Come on!
They were gonna see what Data made his invention was. The can poured to him.
Yeah, the can pulled him?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the port. That's also where Stef was catching a crab in the water barrel.
She stick her head in the water to catch a crab.
This is where Mikey and Bran's dad works. It's a museum. It's called the Flavel Museum. I don't know what it is in the movie, but it's where they go to see their dad at work. We're on our way to the Goondocks, which is Mikey and Bran's house. It's just a few minutes from downtown Astoria. You drive along the coast here. We can see all these big boats in the water and stuff. Oh, here it is, the coffee shop. This was a snack shop in the movie. I bought a t-shirt there yesterday. We're just dorking out, hardcore. Like, that's what we're doing in Astoria, is just visiting all the places from the Goonies, and it's so fun. And every night we're watching the Goonies. So we parked at the coffee shop down at the bottom, and now we're walking up the hill around a corner, and then the house is actually on a private drive, but apparently foot traffic is okay. There's a sign at the bottom near the mailboxes, so we'll go up there and read the sign, and we'll be sure to, you know, abide by whatever they prefer. We'll see if we can catch a glimpse.
I hear sea lions. Do you hear them? Do you guys hear them going, arr, arr, arr?
Yeah, sea lions.
Do you hear the sea lions?
Yeah.
What does the sea lion say?
Oh, oh, oh.
Okay, what are we going to see?
The Goonies house.
Where is it?
Right there. That's Data's house, but it used to be blue, and now it's brown.
Yeah, you remembered?
Look, Mikey has his own play hill.
He has his own pile of rocks.
Yeah.
There's someone right here. Okay, here we are. There's someone in the driveway.
Okay, we should get going.
We
buy the house.
Too bad it's not
for sale. I would love to buy the Goonies house. We could make it an Airbnb and like recreate the interior to look just like the movie.
We did it, you guys.
Yeah.
We saw the Goondocks.
My favorite characters is Trunk and Andy, but I like Trunk the most.
Trunk is great, huh?
Yeah.
And he's so nice to Slaw.
And he's doing, and he puts whipped cream on his face.
Now we're at Warren Field, down the street and around the corner from the Goonies house. In the movie, you see Andy with her cheerleading friends on this field at the beginning of the movie.
I found a spot that's nice and cool. Yeah. This is the field where Andy was teaching the kids how to dance. Do you want to pretend with Mama? You could teach her how to dance?
Sure.
Or she could teach you how to dance.
Yeah. I don't know how to dance.
And you want Mama to teach you?
Yeah.
Want Mama to be Andy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look, I don't like wet grass, but I like shady. It's a problem.
Well, Papa looked it up, and it turns out this isn't Warren Field. Warren Field was a few blocks that way, and it was torn down in 2015. So this is Columbia Field, but it's close enough. We're just pretending anyway. This afternoon, we're taking a stroll down the Astoria Riverwalk, and it's 3.5 miles each way along the water. And we see these big barges, we see docks, we see boats. We see, oh, we hear sea lions. It's just so pretty. It goes in and out. Well, we just started, but it's going in and out of these wooded areas that are all dense and green, and it's this nice paved trail so we can push the stroller. And it's right across the street from that coffee shop down the block from the Goonies house. So all this stuff is kind of in this area we've honed in on that we really like spending time in.
I think that's the Goonies boat, that stuff in the cave.
The Goonies boat that's stuck in the cave?
I think this frame might sum up the feel of Astoria in a lot of ways because it's right by the water and everything's like a little bit rusty or damp or maybe a little dilapidated. Not everything. There's brand new hotels being built too. But as you're driving around and looking around, you see lots of beautiful old houses. The town has a lot of character. It feels historic. It feels like a historic fishing town or something like that.
Lyndon, tell me about this tree.
It has a whole room in it.
Give me a tour of your whole house up here, okay?
My bed is right here. This is my composting toilet, and this is my sister Anna's room.
You mean Anna Maple?
Yeah. My kitchen is right here. Would you like a popsicle? It's a maple leaf popsicle.
Where did you get it?
From the fridge.
You borrow a life jacket and then you put it back when you're done for kids. It's pretty thoughtful. Someone barfed on their life vest and put it back, and now that's really, really gross. It's just a bunch of ants eating something that's on a life vest. Okay.
Are you pooping, Olive?
You can do it in the potty next time. No, you can still do it in your diaper. Poor Olive. Two is a funny age because she's not yet potty trained, but she knows when she has to go and she retreats and like goes around the corner. It's just a funny age. Poor baby. Do you want to hold my hand?
No.
No way does she want to hold my hand.
You can do it. Balance.
Balance.
Balance. Balance.
Jump?
No.
No. You want to step here?
Me.
Or go down?
Me. Go down.
Okay. Can I help you? I can't. No. She won't let me help her do anything.
I did it.
You did it. It's just like the Goonies, but our own version.
Look what's on the bridge. Look what's
on the bridge.
Ah.
What is it?
Look. Whoa, it's a bone.
Whoa. You know what that's I feel like, guys? Next. I feel like we're the Goonies.
Next.
That's Andy.
Andy,
I'm
Andy.
Who's Maple then? Stef?
Or,
and Olive's Chunk. I don't know what it is. Let's go look. They're wondering if it's sloth.
It's Sasquatch. Is it? What is it, Lyndon? Too scary?
Olive, come here. Let's check out this Sasquatch. Let's check it out. It's a monster.
What is it, Maple?
What is
it? I'm going to hug him.
Oh, that's nice.
But he has a sad face.
Maybe the Sasquatch is just lonely. Now he feels better.
Do you want to sleep? I love you. Look at his butt.
Yep.
That's a big butt.
This really is the cutest.
What does it say on the bus, Lyndon? What does that say, Maple? What does it, read the letters.
I feel pretty good about being at the Astoria KOA because there's a bunch of things that the kids can do even though a lot of it's closed and social distancing and raining and smoke. There's a lot of things that we're working against right now, but even considering all those things, there's quite a few activities here that the kids can do. There aren't many kids here, so the playground is often completely empty. And same with, there's swings up there, there's a tetherball area. We're able to keep ourselves busy and entertained all morning long. What you doing? You guys mining for gold?
Yeah.
What did you find? Anything good?
You're not gonna believe what I found.
What is it?
What?
What? Is that
gold?
Yeah!
Show me again. Oh, wow. Gold and pearls?
Yeah.
It's a treasure just like a pirate will find. You got some sand in your cast?
Yeah.
You got some sand in there? Now I'm just gonna get the butt crack of the couch because lots of stuff gets stuck in there.
That's his butt.
Yeah. Mabel's getting a good view.
Mabel just pulled up a chair. Mabel, what are you looking at?
What is that?
A unicorn.
What day is it?
My birthday.
Maple said, that is so huge.
That's so huge.
It's Lyndon's fifth birthday and it's pouring rain outside. So it's really cozy in the Airstream.
Happy birthday.
Make a wish. It's Lyndon's birthday today. I know it's hard. Hey, I have a good idea. What if you let Mabel open this one and then you opened the other one?
Yeah.
That is really going with the flow.
Wow, Lyndon.
You must be five.
I know, let's go.
Olive just wants cake. She's mad that we stopped the cake train.
Cake train.
A pretzel?
What is it?
It's a book.
About?
Bugs!
Now, Grandma picked this one out.
Can you look on this
it's
box?
It's a jewelry box. Your own jewelry box.
What?
With your own bracelet. There's a secret compartment. You pull this little tab.
Thank you, Grandma.
Beautiful. What's on there?
A unicorn.
And look, this box can hold all the rings that you got in there. You want me to give them to you so you can stick them in your box?
Sure.
Okay. Lyndon had two birthday presents to open, and she was so nice to let Maple open the first one. And it worked out because Maple ended up loving that first present, and Lyndon ended up loving her second present.
My favorite bug is butterflies.
Yeah?
Yeah. My favorite bugs are these.
That's a pretty cool one. That's a dung beetle.
A dung beetle?
Yeah, it rolls balls of poop.
Ew.
See? It rolled that big ball of poop all by itself.
Ew. Oh, I think I know those. Dung beetles?
Yeah, that's what they do all day. They roll, they find poop, and they roll it into a ball. A beautiful ball, and then they're proud of it.
I so love Filina. I like chocolate, too.
Just like?
Chunk.
You could pretend that's the ice cream that Chunk was trying to eat.
Mm-hmm. They're gummy berries.
There you go.
How did the jewel mining go today?
It was really fun. Everyone got soaking wet, but it was really fun. They got some really big ones, like, yeah. Oh, that's the secret compartment.
Oh, Lyndon, you're so lucky to have such a nice birthday.
Yeah.
What did you do on your birthday, Lyndon? What did we watch?
We watched Elsa. Can we watch the rest of it?
Yeah, we can.
Okay, come on. Watch the whole thing.
Let's
come
on.
The I don't know how this happened.
What is it?
It's like letters bouncing around like this.
What is it, Lyndon?
A real caterpillar.
Yesterday was Lyndon's birthday, and she got two presents. And one of the presents was a book
all about bugs. And there was a whole section on caterpillars and centipedes and millipedes and roly-polies. So this is really fresh on our minds in our learning. We learned all about these yesterday. Bugs would rather not be touched, but if you're super gentle, it might be okay.
I touched him, Mom. I caterpillar. Take her shoes. She pet him too much.
Yeah, pet him very gentle.
Can I look at this unicorn for a minute?
What do you want to name her, Maple?
Winnie Puppy, Winnie Fluffy Puppy. Punny. Winnie Fiff, Winnie Punny, Fluffy Punny. That's her name.
That's a good name.
Guess where we are. Remember the restaurant? The Fratelli's hideout?
This was where the restaurant was.
Yeah. We have some sleeping sisters, though.
Let's wake them up. Maple?
She's still sleeping.
Oh, she's a sleepy baby.
What do you remember about the restaurant?
There was sloth.
Sloth?
Yeah.
What's the deal with sloth?
He's a head shaped like an egg. And he has some eyes that are kind of weird, and he's so big and strong.
And who's his best friend?
Chunk.
Yeah.
Love Chunk! Chunk's so funny!
Tell me about Chunk.
Chunk's so funny. He was sitting in his chair, and his chair was upside down while he was sitting. He's funny. Chunk's the funniest.
Did his chair fall over?
Yeah, he was like...
How did Chunk meet Sloth?
The Fratellis put Chunk in the dungeon with Sloth, and then Chunk saw Sloth, and Chunk was scared. And then they became best friends forever.
How did they become best friends?
Because he shared his chocolate ball with him.
Do you remember when he looked through the coin and he saw the big rocks? And he said, this must be it. We could find the treasure.
What's the treasure?
All the jewels and gems.
Well, maybe the treasure is Sloth.
Oh!
Pretty view. This might be the best view we've
that
seen.
That is Mom. That is Papa.
You can do upside down.
We're at Ecola State Park, and it's in Cannon Beach. This is where the Fratelli's restaurant was. In the movie, they put a bunch of driftwood and stuff like that to cover up these picnic tables. Wouldn't they just have moved the picnic tables?
Maybe they're bolted down.
They're right so there. Cute. You guys, I've never seen one this furry.
Hi, caterpillar.
It's fun to see him inch along. Look, he's walking up a piece of grass. He's super cute. Yeah.
Gummy bear.
Monster's coming?
He's sticky.
No.
But not what crabs do. Have shell on crabs.
Yeah, crabs have shells and snails have shells. But slugs don't have shells.
What did you find?
We found a slug. We've been searching for caterpillars because there's a bunch of caterpillars all around if you look closely. But I found a slug.
Can people have it on your finger?
No, slugs are like...
Did I lick you?
Yeah, they're slimy.
Ew.
No climbing on rocks.
But we really want to. Golden sea lions.
Yeah, maybe we can see them here.
I see sea lions. Let's stop reading these signs because I want to go to the beach.
Deal.
Okay, come on.
Today we decided to come down to Cannon Beach. We saw it from afar a few days ago, but today we're standing right on the beach. And this is where, in the beginning of the movie, there's a car chase and there's a Jeep rally going on, and the Fratellis blend into the Jeep rally and all the cars are driving on this beach.
This is where Mama Fratelli drove her Jeep onto the beach. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
And she said, have some faith in your old mother and hold on to your seat. Hang on to your hat.
Going on Cannon Beach?
Yeah, isn't it beautiful?
Yeah, it is beautiful. I love Cannon Beach.
You want to go see the biggest rock in the world?
Yeah.
Biggest rock in the world.
Papa, look what I found. A lady kelp.
A lady kelp? Is that a man kelp?
Hello, you fish. Hi, it's a
mommy.
Okay.
Yummy dip of you.
Beach yoga. Look at me too.
Yeah. Big wave got you?
Yeah.
What happened, Olive? Big wave got Olive?
Surprise wave, and it came all of a sudden and it just got everybody wet.
Big wave got you?
Yeah.
Big wave got you all wet?
Yeah.
Who saved you?
You.
Yeah, Papa saved you.
I mean, we're talking like it was like that big of a wave, but it came out of nowhere. We thought we were in the clear and all of a sudden there was a wave just rushing up the beach.
You want to go change clothes? Okay, let's go get dry. It says it might have animal poop in it, like cat poop.
Come on, Olive, it's dirty water. It's poopy.
We gotta wash hands thoroughly before eating.
I'm scared.
Right now, we're just trying to get from the beach to the car. Not that far at all, but it's taking a really long time because there's all these little things that are so interesting to them. Just like what looks like a normal bush? No, it's a fort and it has to be played in.
Where are you, Maple?
I'm in the tree. Maple, let's go now!
Pretty hard to walk 2 blocks.